Here we are supposed to write the program in Java in order to print this pattern. So consider the user input of our n is 5. If you observe this particular code, this is your actually hollow diamond. So instead of this, wherever I have written the capital letter S, we'll replace this by spaces and you will obtain the hollow diamond right within the stars. So how it is working, if you observe, first of all, how stars are printed, right? In the first row, if you observe, 3 stars are printed, then again 1 space, empty space, and then again we are printing 3 stars. Then we move to the next line. In the next line, there are 2 stars, then there are 3 space, if you observe, and then again 2 stars are printed. Change the line again. After that, if you see in this row number, row 3, 1 star, then 5 spaces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay. And then we have 1 star here. Again, change the line. In the next line, again 2 stars, print 2 stars, then print 3 spaces, then print 2 stars. Change the line. In the next line, again 3 stars, then 1 space, and then 3 stars. So we are supposed to generate this sequence of numbers, right? How can we do that? So I'll take the variable, let us say stars, and if you observe this, the value of star starts from 3. And how can we obtain this? If you write here, let us say star equals to n by 2. So 5 by 2 is 2. If I add 1 in this, you will get the value 3. In the similar way, 7 by 2, right, plus 1. So this 1 is added so that we get the exact starting value of this stars, right? Now, once it is done, if you observe, the spaces are starting from 1. So I will take one more variable named spaces, and I will start that from 1. So let me go to the editor. So first of all, I will write here int stars equal to n by 2 plus 1. Okay. Once this is done, I will take one more variable spaces, and spaces are starting from 1. Right. Now, if you consider this condition, that is while, okay, if you consider if your I, the row number, is less than or equal to n by 2. So in that case, what is happening? The value of stars are decreasing by one step. If you observe here, 3 minus 1, 2. Again, you decrease this 2, this becomes 1, right? So if I is less than, that is row number is less than or equal to n by 2, the value of stars should be decreasing and the value of spaces must be increasing. So let me write that part. So here within this loop, I'll write here if I is less than or equal to n by 2. So in that case, what I'll be doing, stars I'll decrease by 1. Why? Because you can see here very clearly the value of stars are decreasing by 1 and the value of spaces are increasing by 2 steps, right? Under this condition, till your I is less than or equal to n by 2, right? So here spaces are increasing by 2. Now in the else part, what is happening? If you observe here, the moment your value of this star becomes your 1, then the value of stars will be increasing in the else part. So in the else part, stars are increasing by 1 step. And if you observe here, the value of spaces are decreasing by 2. So I'll write here spaces, I'll decrease by 2. Okay. Now let me print the value of this star, this star, space and star, so that you can observe the output. So let me write here system.out.print. So here I'll print the value of star, then stars, right? Stars, then with some space. So after that, I will print the value of spaces. Okay, let me write here spaces, and then again some gap, and then finally again I'll print the value of stars in order to check that whether we are getting that numbers or not in the sequence, right? So let me run this. So I'll put the input 5 so that this outputs, right, this set of numbers are generated or not, in order to check it. So enter n. So I'll enter 5 here. So you see 3 1 3, 3 star, then 1 space, and then 3 star, right? Then 2 star, 3 space, 2 star, 1 star, 5 spaces, 1 star, then 2 stars again, 3 spaces, and then 2 stars again, 3 stars, 1 space, 3 stars. Now if you observe here, inside this I loop, I will write a loop for j which will print 3 stars first, then another loop which will print the space, and then the third loop which will print the stars again, right? So I will just comment out this line. Now let me hide this part. Okay, so I'll write a for int j. I will start from 1 and j will go till stars, because first of all I need to print stars, and j will increase every time by 1. Okay, fine. Now here I'll be printing without new line. I'll print the value of stars. So star, some gap I will provide here. Then in the similar way, I'll write a loop for k which will print the stars. No, this time spaces, right? Once stars are printed, we need to print the value of this, what is called your stars as well, right? Sorry, once you have printed the stars, you need to print the value of spaces. So here I will print spaces. Okay, now once your spaces are printed, after that again we need to print star, yes or no? That means three star first, then space, and then again stars. So that's why first loop, first this j loop will print the stars, this k loop will print the spaces, and after that again this l, I'm writing the variable here l will print the stars again, right? And here l increases by one step every time. Okay, so these are your stars printed. Let me run this code. So I will put the value n as 5, so you can see the hollow diamond clearly, right? For n equals to 5. So if I write s wherever, I will write s, so all this in the spaces s will get printed. Okay, now let me run it again. Let me give a larger input, let's say 11, so you can see the hollow diamond for the input 11, right? So if you observe one thing clearly here in this program, the value of your stars are increasing, or start initial value of stars is from n by 2 plus 1, right? Because of this structure, and then spaces are starting from 1, and this line number, from line number 29 to line number 38, is helping you to manipulate the value of stars and spaces in this way. So if we know the exact value of stars and spaces, then we can just use loops. So first of all, we are using the j loop for printing 3 stars, then k loop for printing the space, and then l loop for printing the stars again, and hence we get this hollow diamond. Okay, I hope this program is clear to you.